Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And today we shall address one of the most fundamental questions: when does a Mahadasha change, or when do we feel that my Mahadasha has changed? Or this can work for Antardashas also, because many times I get many mails where people tell me that my Mahadasha has changed, but I don't see any difference in my life. I don't see my life has improved, or there are changes externally, but I feel as if I'm the same person, all right? Or I feel as if I'm the same, but there are no major changes actually. Well, you have to always understand, whatever the horoscope says, whatever the majority planets indicate, that is something which you will always feel irrespective of dashas, okay? But the dasha changes the focus. So many times people think that dasha changes the person. No, it doesn't change the person. It changes the person's focus actually. So no Mahadasha can change you actually. The Mahadasha just shifts the focus. Okay, so I'll be doing a series of Mahadashas and Dashas later on. But this video will help you to identify using transits when a particular dasha, which has already started supposedly for you, gets activated. Okay, and I will also explain with the example chart here. So therefore, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your dashas, then you can always go down to the description section of my videos, where you will find the link to my website to book a personalized reading session with me. All right. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So what's the rule actually? The rule is, suppose your Mahadasha has changed. Okay, so let me share the screen. Then you will understand much better. Screen share. Okay. Okay, the screen is sharing. Yes. Okay. So I have made a example horoscope for explaining this principle, and this is you can do this for any time, day, place, doesn't matter. So I have taken this today's example, 14th May 2020, hopefully, and Thursday, and time of birth is 22:26, which means 10:26 p.m. in India, Kolhapur, Maharashtra. All right. And as usual, today moon is in Dhanishta when I am recording this video, which is in Aquarius. So Dhanishta is lorded by Mangal, as we all know, Mars. So his Mahadasha will start from Mars, all right? So this is his Mars Mahadasha. And he is in third pada of Dhanishta. So like half, more than half of his Mars Mahadasha has already passed. Okay, so if you see this 7 years difference, this is less than 3.5 years. Okay, now ignore that. So the point here which I wanted to say is, imagine this was a normal person's horoscope. Okay, or imagine you were wanting to see when Mars Dasha will be activated for this person. So how would you do that? So imagine that this person was in Moon Mahadasha, okay, because after Moon, Mars will come. So imagine he was born on Moon Mahadasha, okay, and imagine that his Mars Mahadasha just started 2 months, 3 months back. Just imagine like this. Then when will his Mahadasha actually start? So what should you do? You have to check by transit which date is the new moon Amavasya occurring in the ascendant, all right, after the start of the Mahadasha. So let's assume today his Mahadasha started. Okay, let's assume this is a normal person of 20, 30, 40 years, and today his Mahadasha started, all right. And then he comes and asks you, when will my Mahadasha start giving results? So the answer is, you will see results from that very day. But till the time there is this new moon in your ascendant, not moon sign, okay, your lagna, rising sign, first house ascendant. So if you see, this chart is of a Sagittarius rising, because number 9 is in the first house. So therefore, now you have to check when can be there a new moon in his first house. Okay, new moon means Amavasya. Sun and moon are in the same sign, all right. So we all know the times when sun changes a zodiac sign. So for example, roughly around 15th or 14th or 16th of every month, sun will change the sign. Okay. So for example, today is 14th May, and you see sun is in 0 degree of Taurus. It has entered Kritika Nakshatra, second Pada. Okay. So either on, it can sometimes be 13 or 17 also, depending on that. But roughly you could say 14, 15, 16, sun will enter. Okay. So now, when sun enters Sagittarius. When does sun enter Sagittarius? Sun enters Sagittarius on 15 December. Okay. So 15 December of every year, approximately, sun will enter the sign of Sagittarius. And because this is his rising sign, the Lagna, we need to check when is there a new moon. Okay, so let's go to drikpanchang.com. So here, let's give December. So let's check for 23rd December 2020. Okay, let's check what's coming. All right, so this is the chart. Let me minimize this. Okay, so this is the chart. Here you see. This new moon has already passed, okay, quite some time. Or maybe this is Adhik Mass is going on that time because of this, the new moon is getting delayed. So let's check for 15th. What's happening on 15th? Okay, 15 December. Let's check for 15 December. There you go. 15 December itself, the new moon is there. Fantastic. Okay. Oh, sun is at 0 degrees. So let's check if it's happening on 14th. Okay. 14 December, somewhere around this time. Interesting. Okay, so there you go. That's the trap you see. We thought this was a new moon, but actually it's not. Because on 28th, this December, this new moon happened in Scorpio, okay, because moon has just crossed the degree of the sun. Okay, so then when we saw 15 December 00, we thought it was a new moon in Sagittarius. It was actually not. Okay, so then that means we have to go to January. Okay, let's go to 12th January 2021. There you go. You see this? Sun is at 28 degrees, moon is at 22 degrees. Okay, so that means this is the day 2021, January 12th. All right. This is the day because on this day, a moon will reach 6 degrees here, and then sun will be in 29 degrees. Okay. So on 13th or 12th night, you could say, as per German time, moon will cross the sun. That means he will have an Amavasya here in Sagittarius. Okay. So on 13th January next year, or 12th January, you could say around those dates, he will have sun-moon conjunction here and moon will cross the sun. All right. So that is the time when he will actually start feeling that my Mahadasha has changed. Why? Because when the Mahadasha changes, a lot of changes happen externally in your life. Okay. But your ascendant shows your life, your focus. Okay. So the things which affect you very much. Okay. Ascendant shows things which affect you very much. So unless the new moon happens in the ascendant, you don't feel as if your life has had a new beginning. Okay. So when there is a new moon in your ascendant, only then you will feel that the first new moon after that Mahadasha starts. Okay, only then you will feel that your life has actually changed. Okay, now what about Antardashas? So which Antardasha is he running now? He is running Mars Mercury. Okay, now Mars Mercury is going to be over by 16th of July. Okay. Then Ketu, then Venus. Okay. So now, how will you know? For Antardashas, you may not get a Amavasya in the ascendant because your Antardasha may be less than 1 year. Okay. So, for example, if you check here, Mars K2 is only 5 months, okay, July to December within this year. So it is not possible that he gets another new moon in Mars K2. Okay, it's not possible. In fact, I mean in his ascendant. Okay, in fact, the first new moon which he will get for this Mahadasha won't be even in K2. It will be in Venus. Okay, because Venus is starting from July, December this year, and we saw this date. This is January next year. Okay, keep that in mind. Now, what should you do regarding Antardashas? So, regarding Antardashas, you can use this for Mahadashas also, but I have seen this giving better results in case of Antardashas. Okay, you can check when are things changing in the trines. Okay, so which are the trines to Sagittarius? We have Aries and we have Leo. Okay, so Leo is the nearest trine to, from Sagittarius. If you see, currently Sun will enter Leo fastest because Sun is just 3 houses away, 1, 2, 3, or you could say 4 houses away from Leo. So Sun is the nearest trine. Okay, Leo is the nearest trine. I mean, from the current position of the Sun. Current position means his horoscope position. Okay, not in transit. And this is matching with the current transit because this is today's horoscope. Okay, so don't confuse with that. So now you check when will this new moon be in Leo. Okay, so you go and check. So when does Sun will enter this Gemini? On 15 June, then 15 July it enters Cancer, then 15 August it will enter the sign of Leo. Okay, 15th August. So let's check 15th August, 21st August. Let's check 21st August. Okay. There you see, Moon has just crossed the Sun. Okay, Moon is here, Sun is here. So let's check for 20th. How much degree is the Moon in? Moon is in 10 degree. Okay, so let's check for 19th. 19th August will be the new moon. Okay. There you go. Oh, it's even before actually 18th. Okay, because okay, or you can take morning of 19th because the different degree difference is around 7 degrees. So either on 18th or 19th, he will have a new moon in his 9th house. Okay, which is his trine. So now when this new moon will happen in his 9th house, then what will happen is so suppose we got this date as 19th August. Okay, so then you check what is going on 19th August. So he will run till July. He will be running Mars Mercury, then he will run Mars Ketu. Okay, so Mars Ketu will start from July and then he will get a Amavasya in his 9th house. Okay, so that Amavasya will trigger this Ketu Antardasha and he will start feeling as if his life has changed for the temporary Antardasha. But here is the catch though. Okay, remember this, because his Mahadasha has not got this transit in this Lagna. Okay, because his first transit for the Mahadasha should happen in the Lagna, okay, the Amavasya. And because this will happen only in this Mars Venus, which was January next year, we saw that, right? So therefore, you can conclude that even though he will have this new moon here, okay, when he will run Mars Ketu, he won't feel much difference here. He will still feel as if his life has changed. Of course, Ketu traits will come. Okay, that's there's no doubt about it. And Mars will also give traits. But now here's the main part, because this January next year new moon, which will happen in Sagittarius, will trigger both Mars and Venus, because the Venus Antardasha will also get this, right? Because in January is this Venus Antardasha. Okay, January 2021. So So then he will actually feel that his Mars and Venus are like blazing. Okay, Mars, Venus are like blazing, literally blazing, because that one transit will activate the Mahadasha and the Antardasha also. Okay, and after that, whenever he gets another new moon in his trine, okay, so then when will he get another new moon? This will be after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, around 4, 5 months. Okay. So after 4 months, or after 4.5 months, you can say that he will start feeling the effect of the Amavasya in his fifth house. Okay, and this will happen around when 15th April Sun enters Aries. So this will be around 15 April, 15 May. So he will still be running Venus Antardasha. Okay, Venus is very long, you see. Okay, and he will also get this new moon also, the Leo new moon of next year, and he will also get 2022's Amavasya. Okay, because this will happen somewhere around December 2021 or January 2022, and this Venus is freaking long till February 2022. Okay, so therefore, whenever I suggest remedies to people during consultations, I always check these transits, okay, so that you can identify best periods when you can exactly start off this. Okay, so if you are doing consultations or you have clients, then you should use this rule. Okay, you will see magically things are happening. And always suggest people to do remedies in right times. Okay, you check the dasha first. Don't do reverse engineering. Don't look at transits and look at dasha. That's foolishness. Okay, so first look at dashas, then you look at the transits. Okay, so this is how you know when this will be activated. Okay, and yes, that is all I would say. Thank you for your patience, Drik Panchang. Very nice. Okay, thank you very much for your patience. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your dashas or transits or any other remedies, then you can always go to my website down in the description section. And yes, if you're new, then please like this video, click the thumbs up, and share it with somebody who is inquisitive to know when their dashas will start. All right? God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.